If you love food, you may be familiar with the black truffle. This gastronomic delicacy is enjoyed by many, in pastas, bisques and seafood dishes, but it is also one of the most expensive crops on earth. The Périgord black truffle, scientifically named Tuber melanosporum, is an ectomycorrhizal fungus, meaning the fungi has a symbiotic relationship with the roots of host plants. Due to high worldwide demand, many are searching for ways to increase efficient crop production through symbiotic relationships. This search begins at the basis of fungi knowledge. Few fungi underpin what we know about the kingdom Eumycota. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, or baker's yeast, has been a great model organism for discovering more about these eukaryotes, specifically in the field of genetics. Neurospora crassa has also been a useful model organism to unravel the mysteries of metabolism, development, and evolution of fungi. However, both organisms have their limitations. Scientists knew that another organism would be needed to discover more about the fungi kingdom. In 2003, a proposal by the ectomycorrhizal community to the Energy Joint Genome Institute to genetically sequence a new fungus called the carrier bicolor was approved. It wasn't until 2008 that some evolutionary information was discovered. Through analysis of the L bicolor genome, genes that make up a symbiotic toolbox were found. These include small, secreted proteins that have an unknown function, but are only expressed in symbiotic tissues, so they have a decisive role in symbiosis. Unfortunately, these genes only reflect the evolution of this taxon, so scientists were sent back to the drawing board. In 2010, a massive project was undertaken where the largest and most complex fungal genome was sequenced for the time. The genome of the Tuber melanosporum. A whole genome shotgun strategy was employed, where many overlapping DNA sequences are eventually organized into a whole chromosome, like puzzle pieces coming together to form the full genome picture. This process was done via a highly accurate computer called ARACHNE. First, the DNA is isolated and broken into fragments. Electrophoresis sorts these pieces into sizes from small to large, and paired-end sequencing then connects the fragments into one whole genome. From the shotgun approach, a large discovery was made. The T. melanosporum has a 125 megabase genome with no evidence for whole genome duplication. This is significantly more than the previously largest fungal genome, the L. bicolor, which has a 65 megabase genome. Although this organism is significantly larger than any other sequenced sac-shaped fungi, ascomycete, many genes are conserved across time. Conservation of genes displays that symbiosis is an ancient innovation with many toolboxes for different species. This confirmed the 2008 study, but displayed that there are different mechanisms in each fungi to achieve the same symbiotic relationship. This 2010 study was not only revolutionary for the discovery of evolution of ascomycetes, but also answered scientists' questions to improve truffle production to satisfy world demand. PFAM classification was used in research and is the process of classifying proteins coded by the genome sequenced. PFAM classification revealed that it's not the quantity of proteins such as nutrient exchange transporters that can support the symbiotic relationship between the host plant and the fungi, but the number of transporters expressed at the symbiotic interface. Transporters enable flux of nutrients to areas of need, specifically for symbiosis. The protein classification also showed an almost complete absence of highly similar genes, meaning the genome is compact. A compact genome displays that the T. melanosporum has many adaptive mechanisms, therefore it can be a symbiont for a diverse range of soils and potential hosts. By identifying proteins within the T. melanosporum, scientists and farmers compare fungi with a range of hosts and soils to test adaptability, potentially increasing production. It is not just the increase in production, but the decadent truffle flavour that people demand. This flavour is produced by the mating of fungi. Gene analysis revealed that sexual reproduction is controlled by two different mating type genes. One gene encodes for an alpha box domain, and the other codes for a high mobility group DNA binding protein. This was discovered by both of these loci found in two different naturally occurring strains. Hence, the previous theory that the T. melanosporum can self-fertilize is disproved. The T. melanosporum is therefore classified as heterothallic, meaning it cannot mate with itself. Since the T. melanosporum cannot mate with itself, cultivation will improve by pairing host plants with different strains of opposing mating types to increase production. This study gave insight into the basis of symbiosis, not yet addressed in Ascomycota genomics. The discovery of the T. melanosporum genotype and mating process has acted as a foundation for even more research. Scientists are now testing for different mating types within soil, studying male and female genotypes, and the symbiosis of T. melanosporum with non-ectomycorrhizal plants. With new information constantly emerging, the key to satisfying high demand for truffle dishes is just around the corner. And who knows, the hefty price tag may just become affordable for everyone to enjoy.